Brussels at the European Parliament, and it is a very special moment because this is a time that we have lived up to for the last 3 years. We have now more than 100,000 signatures which we have gathered and collected in Europe, and today we're going to present them to the European Parliament.
Today it was not possible to escape your initiative, that it was very visible and also very hearable, and my team confirmed that in the 10th floor they were able to hear you, so this is a very, very good start. Mutinous scumbag,
pink as the moon. Yes, we can feel it.
Like 250 young people who are now here in Brussels from all over Europe, and they're going to talk with their MEP. So we have MEPs from Germany, the Netherlands and Slovakia, and there are all 8 of them, and the young people will go to them and talk to them and sit down and talk about the issue HIV and AIDS.
En ik denk dat het op zich wel is gelukt om jongeren te laten nadenken over wat HIV/AIDS is, wat het met mensen doet.
Hoe kan er nu voor gezorgd worden dat de EU het ook echt daadwerkelijk doet en dat er ook echt verandering gebracht kan worden?
Ja. Het is voor het werk wat wij in het Europees Parlement doen in de strijd tegen HIV/AIDS, is het ontzettend goed als wij de steun hebben van jongeren die naar Brussel komen met 100.000 handtekeningen maar liefst. En we gaan zeker het materiaal wat ze ons hebben aangeleverd en met de handtekeningen in de achterzak gaan we wat doen.
En ik ben zelf heel erg benieuwd hoe het beleid binnen Europa nou precies wordt opgevangen.
Make a promise that I will act positive with this declaration within the parliament to make sure that in this house, in this parliament, your colours and your action to be positive is heard and seen.
What I noticed when I've talked to politicians is that they're very amazed and also are very happy when they see that young kids are doing something for the society, especially if it comes to HIV and AIDS, and that they want to put the time and the effort to fight this disease.
Because you don't let politicians escape from the commitments they made, and you push because things are possible if you really want them to be possible. And that's why it's extremely, extremely valuable that you come to the European Parliament and really show your commitment. It's your free time, it's your initiative that you take to come here, to travel here. So I thank you for doing that.